Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala abdihi wa rasulihi nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd, ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban bikum. I welcome our dear brothers and sisters in al-Islam to the continuation of our explanation of the Hanbali text Bidayat al-Abid wa Kifayat al-Zahid by the great Hanbali scholar of al-Islam Abdul Rahman ibn Abdullah al-Ba'li rahimahullah. Ya Abdullah, ya Amatullah, this is our fourth majlis in Kitab al-Hajj walhamdulillah, and bi-ithnillahi ta'ala we will complete matters pertaining to Hajj in this majlis. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, we've already discussed the conditions related to Hajj. Upon whom is Hajj an obligation? We talked about the entering of the state of Ihram. We discussed the violations of the state. What is prohibited? And if I did violate the state, what is the penalty due from me? We went on to the actual manner of performing the Umrah. We then went on to the 5 days of Hajj. Each one of them we discussed in detail. Walhamdulillah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, in this majlis, we will be covering the matters pertaining to the hadi, the sacrificial animals. We will also talk about udhiya that you might slaughter in your country, wherever you are, on the day of Eid, inshaAllah. We'll also discuss aqiqah. Because we are talking about sacrifice, we will also talk about the aqiqah. You have a newborn boy in the home, newborn girl in the home. Then we give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by slaughtering these animals, insha'Allah. But before that, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, when the author had stated that you enter into the bait without your shoes on, without your arms with you, and without your khufain, we stated that what is most likely meant when you enter into the haram masjid, don't enter with any of these. That was incorrect. In reality, the author meant entering into the Kaaba. Into the Kaaba, if you have the opportunity of entering into the Kaaba, don't wear your shoes, don't wear your khufain, don't go in with your arms, go in a manner where you are super humble, walhamdulillah. As for having your shoes on or having your khufain on in the haram masjid, there's no problem with that. We know our Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, at times he performed his salah with his shoes on. And so you are wearing your leather socks and you are making tawaf around the Kaaba, no problem at all. But if you have the opportunity of entering into the Kaaba, then the author states it is recommended that you don't have khufain on, you don't have shoes on, etc. Why? This increases your super state of humility bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, so that you are super humble, walhamdulillah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, we now move on to the next chapter, and this is the distribution of the hadi, insha'Allah. The author states, وَيَتَعِيَّنْ هَدْيٌ بِقَوْلِهِ هَذَا هَدْيٌ. Or rather, the author states, فَصْلٌ فِي الْهَدِي وَالْأُضْحِيَ وَالْأَقِيقَ. The chapter, the section pertaining to the hadi, sacrificial animal, the udhiya, similar, and the aqiqah, insha'Allah. Al-hadyu ma yuhda lil-haram min na'am, min na'amin aw ghayrihi wa ghayrihi, li'annahu yuhda ila Allah ta'ala. The hadi is the livestock, etc. What is meant by etc. and others similar to it? It could be food. It could be clothing. It could be water. Anything that is gifted to the haram. Anything which is gifted to the haram, that you are distributing this food there in the haram for the sake of Allah. You are distributing water in the haram for the sake of Allah. You are sacrificing this animal and then the meat will be distributed for the sake of Allah. All of this technically falls within the definition of the hadi. And then within the hadi is obviously the animal that we will discuss, insha'Allah. So the word hadi, it is much more general than specifically slaughtering a cow or a goat or a cow, etc. مَا يُهْدَى لِلْحَرَمْ مِنْ نَعَمْ وَغَيْرِهِ لِأَنَّهُ يُهْدَى إِلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. This is where you are offering to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the hadi. And there's obviously a special hadi that you will slaughter if you are doing tamattu hajj, if you are doing qiran hajj. Then there's the udhiya. ما يذبح من إبل وبقر وغنم أهلية أيام النحر بسبب العيد تقربا إلى الله تعالى وهي سنة مؤكدة. Then there is the udhiyah, which is the slaughter of a camel or a cow or a sheep, which is slaughtered during the days of Nahr, the day of Eid, the 10th of Dhul Hijjah, or the 11th or the 12th. And this is you drawing closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we do this in following the sunnah of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And this is a sunnah mu'akkada act. It is not an obligation. It is not wajib. Rather, it is sunnah mu'akkada. وَتَجِبُ بِالنُّذُورِ But it becomes an obligation if you made a nadhar. For example, if I pass in my examination, then I'm definitely going to slaughter an udhiyah. Well, now you obliged it upon yourself. وَالْأَفْضَلُ إِبِلٌ فَبَقَرٌ فَغَنَمٌ The best one is to slaughter a camel, then a cow, and then after this your sheep or your goats, inshallah. Remember, the camel equals 7 shares, the cow equals 7 shares, the goat 1 share, and the sheep 1 share. وَلَا يُجْزِي مِنْ غَيْرِهِنَّ And other animals do not suffice. So you cannot be slaughtering a chicken or a rabbit, etc. وَتُجْزِئُ شَاتٌ عَنْ وَاحِدٍ وَأَهْلِ بَيْتِهِ وَعِيَالِهِ And one goat or one sheep suffices for the individual and for his family, for the people of that home, for that entire family, the one animal suffices, inshallah. Each one wants to do their own, fantastic, walhamdulillah. But one animal suffices for each household. وَبَدَنَةٌ أَوْ بَقَرَةٌ عَنْ سَبْعَةٍ That the cow or the bull or the camel, they suffice for 7 shares, insha'Allah. وَيُعْتَبَرُ ذَبْحُهَا عَنْهُمْ And at the time of slaughter, what counts is the intention. So there's Salman, Ilyas, Fatima, Sumayya, Huda, etc. 7 individuals. The person who is slaughtering at the time of slaughter, you know, it's the intention in the heart that this is for 7 individuals and that counts. He doesn't really need to know each person by their name. He doesn't need to mention each person by their name. As long as, you know, the people, they've been allocated a share in each of these animals, it suffices. Example. Yourself and your family members, 7 of you got together and you purchased a cow, and this cow will be slaughtered in Vietnam, for example. The guy who's doing the slaughtering in Vietnam doesn't need to know your name, your date of birth, you know, all of you family members, whoever participated in the purchase of those shares. He doesn't need to know that. As long as at the time of slaughtering, his intention is, this is for whoever it is meant for. It is for, I'm slaughtering on behalf of, you know, those 7 people or whoever. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows exactly who it belongs to, inshallah. وَسَبْعُ شَاتٍ أَفْضَلْ مِنْ إِحْدَاهُمَا And 7 sheep are better than any one of the others. Slaughtering 7 sheep, is that better than slaughtering 1 cow? The answer is yes. Slaughtering 7 sheep, it is better than وَشَاتُ أَفْضَلْ مِنْ سُبْعُ بَدَنَةٍ أَوْ بَقَرَةٍ وَسَبْعُ شِيَاتٍ أَفْضَلْ مِنْ إِحْدَاهُمَا Excellent. وَلَا يُجْزِئُ إِلَّا جَذَعُ ضَأْنٍ أَوْ ثَنِيُّ غَيْرِهِ It is not valid except with a 6-month-old sheep or a thani of something else. The sheep should be minimum 6 months old. And as for the goat, it should be 1 year old. ثَنِيُّ إِبِلْ مَا لَهُ 5 سِنِينَ A thani of a camel is 5 years old, so a camel 4 years old, not valid, must be over 5. وَثَنِيُّ بَقَرٍ مَا لَهُ سَنَتَانِ As for the cow, it should be the minimum of 2 years old. وَلَا تُجْزِئُ هَزِيلَةٌ Malnutrished type of animal, not valid. وَبَيِّنَةُ عَوَرٍ The animal which is one-eyed, invalid. The one which is araj, it is unable to walk properly, it's limping, etc. And this affects it, then this type of animal will not be valid. وَلَا ذَاهِبَةُ الثَّنَايَا أَوْ أَكْثَرِ أُذُنِهَا أَوْ قَرْنِهَا Also, the author mentions wala. Wala indicates there's difference of opinion with regards to these matters. Which matters there's difference of opinion? That if most of its ear or most of the horn is missing, is broken off, it's cut off, most of the ear and most of the horn. And there's debate with regards to this within the madhab. And the author states that such an animal will not suffice. Most of the horns broken off, most of the ears cut off will not suffice according to the author.
وَسُنَّ نَحْرُ إِبِلٍ قَائِمَةً مَعْقُولَةً
It's recommended to slaughter the camel while it's standing with its left يَدُهَا الْيُسْرَى بِأَنْ يَطْعُنَهَا يَطْعُنَهَا فِي الْوَهْدَةِ
That it is recommended that the camel be standing with its left leg bound and you punch or you stab it, you cut it at the area between the neck and the sternum.
بين العنق والصدر between its neck, the bottom part of the neck. That's where you puncture it, and that's when you know the that's what we call nahar. That's what we call nahar. So your sheep and your goat, you make dhabh, which is slaughter, you cut. Whereas for the camel, you know, it's nahar, which is like you pierce the neck and you drive your knife towards the right or towards the left and you create this puncture there, and that's when you will find all of the blood just flowing out.
وَذَبْحُ بَقَرٍ وَغَنَمٍ عَلَى جَنْبِهَا الْأَيْسَرِ مُوَجِّهَةً إِلَى الْقِبْلَةِ
As for the slaughtering of a cow and the sheep, it's done on their left-hand side while they are facing towards the Qibla. So you put them on the left-hand side, you slaughter on the left-hand side, is done on their left-hand side while facing the Qibla. It's obligatory to mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's name. وَيُسَمِّي وُجُوبًا حِينَ يُحَرِّكُ يَدَهُ بِالْفِعْلِ وَيُكْثِرُ وَيَكُولُ ويكبر ويقول اللهم هذا منك ولك
And at the time of slaughter, when you are moving your blade, you say the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Bismillah, Allahu Akbar. You make the takbir, and you also recommended to say, Allahumma hadha minka walak. Oh Allah, this is from you, and it is for you.
وَوَقْتُ ذَبْحُ أُضْحِيَةٍ وَهَدِي نَذْرٍ أَوْ تَطَوُّعٍ وَمُتَّعَةٍ وَقِرَانٍ مِنْ بَعْدِ أَسْبَقِ صَلَاةِ الْعِيدِ بِالْبَلَدِ
And the time of slaughter for all of these here, it is after Salatul Eid, in the city.
أو قدرها لمن لم يصلي.
Or you wait the duration if you know you're in a place where there's no Salatul Eid, or if you're in a place where you miss Salatul Eid, you wait for that duration, that time to pass, and then you can slaughter.
فإن فاتت الصلاة بالزوال ذبح بعده إلى آخر ثاني التشريك.
And if you miss Salatul Eid, there's no Salatul Eid due to some sort of excuse, or Zawal has come and Salatul Eid hasn't yet been performed, then you can slaughter after Zawal. Inshallah, you have the 10th, the 11th, and the 12th to slaughter. Some scholars allow the 13th, but officially, according to the Madhab, only the 10th, 11th, and the 12th.
وَوَقْتُ ذَبْحِهِ وَاجِبٍ بِفِعْلِ مَحْظُورٍ مِنْ حِينِهِ
As for the animal that you need to slaughter as a penalty, then its time begins from the time that you violated and you have incurred that penalty. So for example, someone put on some perfume, or he covered his head while in the state of ihram, then he's got the three options and he decides he wants to do the slaughter. Well, directly after that, he can do the slaughter because it becomes an obligation upon you, you know, once you've fallen into that error.
فصل ويتعين هدي بقوله هذا هدي
and the hadi is specified. You know, you purchase this animal, but you could, for example, decide that I don't want to slaughter this animal. You could, for example, decide that I want to purchase another animal. But if you have specified after purchase, you said this is my hadi, this animal here, you specified it, then this animal you can't do anything else. You have to slaughter it.
أو بتقليده أو إشعاره
or if, for example, you put like a garland around it or blood marking on it, you know, you specify that this animal, there's nothing else to be done with it except that it will be slaughtered, then you can't do anything else with it. But, you know, you just purchase the animal and, you know, it's your intention is that it's going to be for the hadi, and then something else came up and you sold the animal or whatever, you know, no issues. But if you specified, then you are bound by that specification. وَأُضْحِيَةُ هَذَا بِهَذِهِ أُضْحِيَةٌ أَوْ لِلَّهِ وَنَحْوِهِ. And with regards to the udhiyah, it becomes specified. If you say this is the udhiyah or this is for Allah, then you can't do anything else with that animal. The author states, وَلَا يَجُوزُ إِعْطَاءُ الْجَازِرُ أُجُرَتُهُ مِنْهَا. You cannot pay the butcher, the one who's slaughtering, the one who's skinning, pay them like, you know, their wages from a portion of that animal. So you say to him, you know what, you do all of the cleaning and I will give you 2 kgs, 10 kgs of the meat. You know, that's your payment. No, you cannot do that. وَيَجُوزُ هَدِيَّةً وَصَدَقَةً. But you can give him a gift, you can give sadaqa, etc. from the animal, no problem. وَلَا يُبَاعُ جِلْدُهَا. You can't sell its skin or its leather. وَلَا شَيْ مِنْهَا. Or any portion of it. All of this is for the sake of Allah. You cannot be benefiting from this here. بَلْ يَنْتَفِعُ. You cannot be benefiting in terms of sale. But you can benefit from the leather. You can make some leather jacket, you can make a leather pouch, some carpet, no problem at all. وَسُنَّ أَنْ يَأْكُلَ وَيَهْدِيَ وَيَتَصَدَّقْ أَثْلَاثًا. It's recommended to divide it into 3 parts, to eat 1/3, to give as gifts to friends and family, etc., another 1/3, and to distribute in charity 1/3. Similarly, one should eat from the voluntary hadi and the udhiyah, even if it is one of the obligatory types. The author states, وَأَنْ يَأْكُلَ مِنْ هَدِيِهِ التَّطَوُّعُ وَمِنْ أُضْحِيَةٍ وَلَوْ وَاجِبَةً. That your udhiyah and your hadi, you know, you did the tamattu hajj or the qiran hajj, you did the udhiyah in your country on the day of Eid, recommended for you to eat from that, insha'Allah. وَيَجُوزُ مِنَ الْمُتْعَةِ وَالْقِرَانِ. You did udhiyah, I mean, you did the hadi for the tamattu hajj or for the qiran hajj, you can eat from that sacrificed animal. وَيَجِبُ أَنْ يَتَصَدَّقْ بِمَا يَقَعْ عَلَيْهِ إِسْمُ اللَّحَمْ. And it is a must, even from your udhiyah, that you must distribute a portion of it, you know, as sadaqah, in charity. You can't keep the entire thing for yourself. You must give a portion out, you know, as sadaqah, insha'Allah. وَيَعْتَبِرُ وَيَعْتَبَرُ تَمْلِيكُ لِلْفَقِيرِ فَلَا يَكْفِي إِطْعَامُهُ. And you should gift it, you should give it as sadaqah to some of the poor. And it wouldn't suffice that you made some meal and you invited the poor to eat from it. No, you need to give them the actual meat. You need to give, like example, 1 kilogram, let's say the sheep totaled up to 25 kilograms of meat. You need to give minimum, let's say, you know, 1 kilogram. This is charity, and you give it to the poor and they become the owners of that. Not that you just invite them and they eat a meal. No. وَإِذَا دَخَلَ الْعَشْرُ حَرُمَ عَلَى مَنْ يُضَحِي أَوْ يُضَحَى عَنْهُ أَخْذُ شَيْءٍ مِنْ شَعْرِهِ أَوْ ظُفْرِهِ أَوْ بَشَرَتِهِ إِلَى الذَّبْحِ وَسُنَّ حَلْقٌ بَعْدَهُ. When the 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, when they enter, then it is impermissible for the one who is going to do the udhiyah, or having one offered, or the udhiyah is to be done for him. He sent it to another country, so the udhiyah is going to be done for him. It's impermissible for this person to remove their hair, their nails, etc., except until the animal is slaughtered. And it is recommended after that for you to shave, for you to, you know, remove all of these long nails, etc. So for the 10 days, according to the official position of the madhab, it is haram, it is impermissible for you to clip your nails and trim your hair. Faslun. Now the author discusses the aqiqah, insha'Allah. Wal aqiqatu sunnatun mu'akkadatun. It is an emphasized sunnah. Fi haqqi al-ab. Upon who? Upon the father. Wa hiya anil ghulam shatani mutaqaribatani sinnan wa shabahan. That you need to slaughter 2 sheep or 2 goats which are similar in appearance, similar in age. This is for the boy. Fa in udima fawahidatun. And if both are unavailable, then one will suffice. If you cannot do 2 sheep, then one will suffice, insha'Allah. وَعَنِ الْجَارِيَةِ شَاتٌ. And with regards to a jariya, with regards to a girl, then it is 1, insha'Allah. So what's the ruling with regards to aqiqah? It is sunnah mu'akkada, highly emphasized. How many? 2 for the boy and 1 for the girl. And if you don't have 2 for the boy, one will suffice, insha'Allah. The author states, وَهِيَانِ الْغُلَامِ شَاتَانِ مُتَقَارِبَتَانِ سِنًّا وَشَبَهًا فَإِنْ عُدِمَ فَوَاحِدَةٌ وَعَنِ الْجَارِيَةِ شَاتٌ for the girl one, وَلَا يُجْزِئُ بَدَنَةٌ أَوْ بَقَرَةٌ إِلَّا كَامِلَةً تُذْبَحُ فِي سَابِعِ. And we cannot slaughter the cow and say, well, you know what, the cow suffices as 7 shears, so this works. No. You have a boy and you want to slaughter cows, you will need to slaughter 2 cows. Each animal, you know, is counted like as one here, inshallah. Each animal on its own. And so 2 cows for the boy, or 2 sheep for the boys, or 2 goats for the boys, or 2 camels for the boy, etc. But the 7 shares do not work when it comes to the matter of aqiqah, insha'Allah. وَلَا يُجْزِئُ بَدَنَةٌ أَوْ بَقَرَةٌ إِلَّا كَامِلَةً تُذْبَحُ فِي سَابِعِ وَلَا وَلَادَتِهِ وَيُسَمَّى فِيهِ. And the author states that on the 7th day, the 7th day after birth, this is when, you know, you should do the slaughtering, and this is when you should also name the kid. You should name the kid and you should slaughter on the 7th, the author mentions. How do we count the 7th day? Well, the day the kid was born is counted as the first day. Kid was born on Saturday. So the next week, Friday, is when we will slaughter the aqiqah, insha'Allah. فَإِنْ فَاتَ فِي أَرْبَعَ فَفِي أَرْبَعَةِ عَشَرَ فَإِنْ فَاتَ فَفِيهِ فَفِي أَحَدَ وَفِي أَحَدَ وَعِشْرِينَ وَلَا يُعْتَبَرُ الْأَسَابِيعُ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ. So on the 7th you do the slaughter. If you miss that, on the 14th. If you miss that, on the 21st. After that, we don't count the 7s. You slaughter on the 22nd, the 23rd, the 24th, etc. وَلَا يُكْسَرُ عَظْمُهَا وَطَبْخُهَا أَفْضَلُ. And when you are preparing, when you are cutting up the animal, etc., you know, it's not liked that, you know, you break the bones of the animal. This is like a good omen. This animal here is like, you know, giving thanks to Allah with regards to the kid who has come. And so don't break the bones of the animal, even after the animal is dead, etc. It is better to cook it and include, you know, something sweet with it. وَطَبْخُهَا أَفْضَلُ وَيَكُونُ مِنْهُ بِحُلْوَ. You know, something sweet, you know, mix it with that food, inshallah. وَحُكُمُهَا كَأُضْحِيَةِ فِيمَا يُجْزِئُ وَيُسْتَحَبُّ وَيُكْرَهُ. And the rulings with regards to aqiqah and the type of animal, etc., and what is permissible, not permissible, it is the same as the udhiyah, inshallah. لَكِنْ يُبَاعُ جِلْدٌ وَرَأْسٌ وَسَوَاقِطُ. But here, you are allowed to sell portions of it, like the skin, the head, the discarded remains. They can be sold in order to give its value in charity. So you can sell the head, you can sell the leather, and you take that money and you give it in charity. Whereas when it came to udhiyah, you cannot sell any portion of it at all, even if you want to give it in charity. وَإِنْ اتَّفَقَ وَقْتُ أَقِيقَةٍ وَأُدْحِيَةٍ أجزأت إحداهما عن الأخرى. If the time of aqiqah and the time of udhiyah, they coincide, then one will suffice for the other. MashaAllah. 2 birds, 1 stone. And so if they coincide, then you can do both of them with the intention of just having one done, بإذن الله تعالى والحمد لله. يا عبد الله يا أمة الله. With that, we come to the end of Kitab al-Hajj. We have covered the 5th pillar of al-Islam, والحمد لله. يا عبد الله يا أمة الله. We ask Allah for the best in this world and in the hereafter. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for knowledge which is beneficial. Keep us away from knowledge which is not beneficial. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us. We ask Allah subhanahu to make our children, our kids, the coolness of our eyes. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us tawfiq to make amal upon whatever we have learned, to make it a proof for us and not a proof against us. هذا wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala abdihi wa rasulihi nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.